Welcome to this chat with Chair. Budget 2021 is around the corner. We are extremely privileged and delighted to have Mr. S.P. Shukla, who is a member of the Group Executive Board of Mahindra Group and also as Group President. He is responsible for the defense, aero, agri and steel sector. Interestingly, all the four sectors in the limelight currently for different reasons. In this position, he is chairman of the board of several companies engaged in designing and producing armored vehicles, radars, naval systems, aerostructures, and special alloy steel. He has also recently taken over the responsibility of several companies involved in the Mahindra's agribusiness portfolio. In this that capacity, he is appointed as the chairman of the Mahindra EPC Irrigation. And additionally, he also serves as the chairman of Mahindra CIE Automotive India. He is also the chairman of the FICCI Defense Committee. So very warm welcome to you, Mr. Shukla, on this chat
with you
at the budget with FICCI. So last year, the defense sector witnessed multiple reforms, announcements and policy measures by the government of India, including the promulgation of the defense acquisition procedure. And the budget is a very significant document that determines the acquisition program of the government going forward. And in that context, what is your expectation from the union budget for the defense sector that would complement the forward-looking defense acquisition procedure 2020?
You have outlined the circumstances extremely well. Defense acquisition procedure was unveiled just a few months back. Our defense forces need to be enabled so that they can avail of DAP. Now, that is something which two things need to work together on. If we look at situation on our northern border and eastern border, there is definitely a need to increase the capital expenditure significantly. Today, it's a reality that a large part of expenditure does happen on OPEX, the operating cost, and leaving somewhat reduced money available for capital expenditure. So I look forward that union government will be able to allocate financial resources for capital expenditure. This is what will be a great enabler for DAP 2020 to proceed forward. In that context, I have one more request and expectation that when capital expenditure budget is planned, a special focus, a special emphasis is kept for Make in India items.
You know, Mr. Shukla, when you were talking about a special emphasis on Make in India items, the government recently, you know, announced a list that they will only buy from India. So, and also there is another thing, which is you know, which is the government's thing of tenders below 200 crores will be you know, reserved for Made in India products. In your view, what could be done through the budget or through otherwise to actually enable this to translate into orders for the defense manufacturers in India?
We must appreciate and compliment the government, both Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Finance, to come up with the initiatives which you outlined. Number one, a negative list of 101 items. It was the first time since independence, we have seen a list like that. Great initiative. And second, as you rightly pointed out, order size below certain limit will only be for Make in India products. It will not be a global tender. Both are very welcome initiative. And with your permission, I will add third, government kept aside under a separate head an amount of 53,000 crores which will be used only for Make in India items. It's a very important move because you can have a negative list of many items, if there is no budget kept aside, then you will not be able to procure what defense forces want. My only request in this context will be, policy enablement has happened. All the three moves are welcome move. Never before in the history of defense budget, a government has kept aside a separate budget only for domestic procurement. Last year, the amount was 53,000 crores. I would request that this amount is what needs to go up significantly. It is that rebalancing within the defense budget which will make all the difference. So if I can paraphrase answer to your first question as well as second question, within the defense budget, we are looking at increased emphasis on capital expenditure. And within capital expenditure, we are looking at more emphasis on Make in India portion, which is domestic procurement head newly created. Policy initiatives have been fantastic over the last few years. I think we have the policy environment in place. Now with suitable budgeting, we will enable our defense forces to get what they need.
That's excellent observation, excellent comment there. If I would just extend that question, if the new head for domestic defense procurement, which has been created under the capital acquisition budget, would you like to share with us how it will benefit the domestic, defense private sector as against the domestic defense sector? So what is it that, how is it that we can actually enable the private defense, companies to actually benefit from this? Because the government is laying a lot of emphasis on the private sector to come up in defense. There are two defense corridors. There's a whole lot of other programs there. So how would it benefit?
Thank you so much. I agree with you. So first, capital expenditure within the defense budget, then domestic procurement within capital expenditure. Then we need to have a focus on projects which can generate both jobs as well as domestic production. One example I would like to share. Strategic partnership project was cleared some time ago. Under four major platform categories, India was to have partnership between foreign OEMs and domestic manufacturing industry. The logic, the rationale was that already we have some very capable units in public sector. So first line of manufacturing is in place. In every field, we have some. However, there are some categories where it is advantageous to have a second manufacturing line in the country. Take, for example, aircraft, helicopters. We need a second line of manufacturing in the country in private sector. It will promote efficiency. It will promote competition. But I'm coming to another important part. And this is something very often not always thought through in technology domain. You need a funnel to absorb technology. Now, if you have to absorb all the technology in the world through one single company, whatever be the company, public sector or private sector, your funnel to absorb becomes limited. You need to take technology from different countries in the world. They may be US, UK, France, Russia, different countries in the world. If you have a broader funnel, you absorb more technology into the country, and that creates a technological base for developing our own indigenous technology in future. Strategic partnership project combines the best of the world. It combines a manufacturing base in India in private sector, along with collaboration and partnership of a foreign OEM. This is a model cleared by government quite some time back. And now time has come that with separate budget had already created for domestic procurement, as well as list of negative items being created we have reached a stage where policy enablement has happened. If we proceed with one or two such projects, there is a tremendous ripple effect. I had mentioned some time ago in a webinar, a small car project can have up to 200 vendors in India supplying parts and components. You know, simple examples, somebody will supply windscreen, somebody will supply brakes, seat cover, steering wheel, headlights, tail lights, 200 different suppliers. By the time you reach aircraft, helicopters, such platforms, number of suppliers can reach 1,000. We create a tremendous ecosystem. There is a symbiosis between large companies and small and medium companies. There is no such thing as large versus small. So if there is a strategic partnership with a large company who is the integrator, you find that Indian ecosystem and defense simply takes off with hundreds of vendors and suppliers coming to supply to the large company. And we have created a strong ecosystem which will serve the country for decades. This ecosystem trains engineers, technicians who start joining other companies. So you start with one strategic partner and you are actually creating a trained manpower who in due course will be nucleus of starting many other startups as well as other companies will have ready base to recruit manpower from. This one single initiative can create a tremendous difference without putting any load on exchequer. If we announced one single project in strategic partnership, entire capital expenditure is borne in private sector. Government does not have any burden on its budget. When they start manufacturing, that is when government starts procurement. As a result, this capital expenditure once again gives a boost to the economy, because need of the hour is to push capital formation and capital expenditure in the economy to a good, give a boost to GDP and jobs. So this is where I will stop. This is something I will strongly recommend on top of the great initiatives which Ministry of Defense and Ministry of Finance have taken, which we, on behalf of Defense and Aerospace Committee of FICCI, wholeheartedly welcome and compliment the government for.
Thank you. So, you know, strategic partnership initiative is a new dimension that you brought into that. And, you know, recently, the government is also in a move to try and make India more attractive as a place for manufacturing, defense manufacturing, have increased the, FDI limit for under automatic approval. But that is only one part of the picture. So in your view, what are the steps that the government could take, to further strengthen domestic manufacturing in India? You talked of the strategic partnership initiative, but I'm sure you must have other suggestions that the government could consider. Some of them may be related to the budget, some may be outside the budget.
So you rightly said, ultimately manufacturing happens where the demand is. The moment procurement cycle begins, there is a need to manufacture. Whether it is manufactured outside India or manufactured in India, manufacturing will happen the day demand is created. Our goal is when demand happens, manufacturing happens in India. So we talked about domestic procurement as well as strategic partnership model, which is an approved model already existing in the government's procedures and policies. I find a great enabler has been created by the government, which is defense corridors. If you remember old commerce 200 years ago, 100 years ago, 300 years ago, centers of excellence developed in one industry in towns. Varanasi became a center for saris, Jari ka kaam. Near Varanasi, another small town, Bhadohi, became the center for carpet weaving. Muradabad was the center for making brass vessels and utensils. Centers develop around a town. If we come to recent days, recent times, Tirupur became the center for textile industry. Surat became the center for diamond industry. What happens is when many industries come together, it creates an ecosystem. Their suppliers, their vendors come together. It's a wonderful time-tested concept. Same concept applies today in the industries. Sticking to defense and aerospace, all over the world, defense and aerospace has evolved as a hub. Large OEMs, I think they're well known and they will be flattered. So I'm going to take the names of the great companies. Companies like Airbus, Boeing, or other companies in the sector, wherever they set up their manufacturing base, around them, hundreds of other companies came up and those centers developed. I think defense corridor is a wonderful idea. We have announced one in north and one in south, Tamil Nadu and UP. We believe both in the defense committee, as well as I can speak for myself from Mahindra Defense. We believe this is a great idea. It will lead to creation of ecosystem all around it. So this is one item which I definitely think deserves support and promotion. A lot will depend upon the state government here, besides the central government releasing orders on companies. Defense is one sector where it is difficult to envisage companies coming up without a procurement order in sight, because you cannot sell this to anyone else. It can only be sold to a government. This is an important point which gets often missed. And generally, if you want to sell outside India, the first question is, have you sold within your country? We found this in our armored vehicle experience. After we were able to sell some vehicles in India after designing and developing, our armored vehicles are not going now, are being exported in different parts of the world. They are becoming a major stay of UN peacekeeping force. But first question always is, has your army bought it? Same thing depends. The moment we have startup through strategic partner approach for few sectors, and they will most probably come into defense corridors, you will notice that exports will also pick up. I do believe that our goal which we have set for the country to reach exports of 25,000 crores is eminently achievable, and we will do it. Last 3 years, industry has already tripled its exports. We are confident that that target will be achieved in near future with the support of government, both central and state.
Yeah, I think we're very, very happy that you mentioned this point. It's one of your favorite points. It's unless you buy from Indian companies in India, you won't be able to export. And in addition to what you have actually said very recently, Fiki, the Defense Committee under your leadership, you know, organized bilateral meetings with, whether it was, I think, in Central Asian, country, and also in the ASEAN region. And the defense attaches and the missions abroad are playing a role. So some allocation to them to promote this activity would actually go a long way. I know we are coming to the end of the program, but I'd just like to ask you one other question. The finance minister has said that this is going to be the budget of the century, or the biggest, best budget that is going to be announced. From your perspective, if it includes the points that you made, will it be the best budget, or there is any other point that you would see in the general economy which needs to be done to make it the best budget of the century?
We understand that one of the most difficult jobs in the country is that of the finance minister. We respect the tension, pressure, pulls and pushes from every quarter. In today's difficult corona environment, there is demand from health ministry. There is a demand from education ministry. there is pressure all around, and everyone would like a larger allocation of the overall budget. It's very understandable. We understand, appreciate, and respect the pressures. So it becomes a balancing act at the highest level, keeping in mind priorities of the country. So my only submission is, this is one industry, defense, which actually can make a difference all around in every possible area of impact. I reiterate, this industry can create jobs in a big way. It can reduce imports, which balances our trade deficit. Today, we are the largest or second largest importer of equipment almost every year. We can reduce the trade deficit, which reduces pressure on Indian rupee. We can create jobs, and most importantly, we achieve self-reliance, which cannot be quantified, monetized, or expressed in rupees. But not having to depend on others at the time of requirement, at the time of emergency, at the time when we need it most, is one of the most important areas. So defense actually can help in pushing the agenda of the government in a big way. The non-defense items which I would really look forward to is, if GST, and now I'm talking as a common man, if GST, it was possible to look at reduction in certain important categories, strictly temporary reduction, and people knew that reduction is being made available only for a period of 1 year, so that people know this 1 year they have to maximize their purchases to avail of that benefit. It can give a short-term 1 year boost to demand. It will create definitely some shortfall in government revenues, but it is better than giving subsidy. In my humble opinion, a higher revenue with lower GST has the potential of generating the same amount of tax revenue by giving 1 year boost, and it can revert back. It is important to say that we are giving it for a defined period, which will encourage people to go out and spend. Idea is that expenditure increases, people spend their money, so that economy gets a boost, circulation of money happens, that will be good for the economy. I will stop here because I am not an economist. What I am sharing is my feeling that people should start spending money so that it percolates down from those who have the money to those who don't. Best route is expenditure and not increasing taxation.
Thank you very much, Mr. Shukla. Incidentally, that is also the view of the chief economist of your group, who also goes by the surname of Shukla. But that's another thing there. But in our conversation today, you have actually kept from the beginning to the end, you have kept a very interesting theme, which is demand. You said that if the government allocates a specific amount for domestic procurement, that will create demand, and therefore, the manufacturing would grow. The second one, you said, if you're looking at being able to do import substitution and develop a technology base in India, we need to look at the strategic industry partnership. And even if you're looking at creating a wider market for Indian defense products here, the first is to, focus on the two clusters, you know, Tamil Nadu and UP you talked about. And second is that you said that we need to look at a global market, and we can't create a global market unless we buy in India first and give that. And you have the strategic partnership initiative to assimilate technology. And you use the word the funnel. You said, you didn't say it, but there could be multiple funnels instead of one funnel going in there, and that would actually help India to acquire technology. And you ended by saying that the demand generation would be good if you can find a way to do that. And right throughout, you've been appreciative and complimented, not only the steps taken by the defense minister, but we've also recognized the tremendous pressure which the finance minister is under, and we'll see on the, you know, very shortly on the first the outcome of the budget. So thank you very much for being with us today, and thank you so much for sharing your views so candidly.
Thank you so much, Mr. Shona. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you.